Starting. I'm not seeing it here. Come on. There we go. Finally, I am live. Better early than late. 4 minutes early, according to my TikTok. It'd be 12:56. And I said one. So, hello, Paraghoster. Oh, Tim C, how you doing? I guess it pays to advertise. There's two people already. Yeah, I thought I'd give it a shot. Give it a shot. How are you guys this afternoon? Is my audio coming through all right? I messed around with that demon voice, and I haven't seen if it was going to come through normally after that. I guess you're hearing me. Hopefully. And I am seeing the chat room today. I got messed up yesterday and lost the chat room somehow. Messed around with that program that alters my voice. And once I started messing with that, it screwed up the chat for some reason. Oh, you sound like me, Paraghoster. Just woke up. I'm going to chant something here now, seeing as how it's early. I'm just going to chance this here. And see if this works or not. Where is it? Okay. Let's see. Well, 1, 2, 3. Okay. Well, 1, 2, 3. Okay, that's not working now. Probably because I'm on here. That's okay. Glad you guys are doing well. We start talking about this giant stuff. Get a few more people in here. Right now, I'm seeing five. Two are talking out of five. I did it strange today. I know there's a scheduler built into this stream thing. But when you do that, it schedules it via YouTube. And that's it. So I figured by making the video, my video is sent to YouTube. It's sent to Google+. And it's sent to Twitter. So that's two times more advertising than just making a schedule on YouTube. So that's why I made it. The way I made it. So what do you guys think about these giant stuff? There's a picture, the picture I got up there now, I'm kind of iffy about. If that was one time a real giant, the size of that skull, them people are standing by, that giant would have to be 20 or 30 foot tall. And I don't know if I can believe that. Of course, if it was true, they would have no problem lifting them blocks to stack them up for pyramids, would they? And if you go back and, I gotta back this up somehow. If I can do that now. Oh boy, I'm gonna do that now without messing this up. I hope so. I'll move this down a little bit. There we go. Now I'll move this back up again. Hey, good morning, Lori. Boy. There we go. There's the one I wanted. You know, in Egypt there and them around the pyramids and stuff, this I think is supposed to be Osiris, the sun god. I could be wrong. But over there are these hieroglyphs. Always depict these gods as being giants. I mean, look at the normal sized people bringing them stuff and etc. And it looks like a little kid sitting on the one's lap. They're always depicted that way over there in the land of the pyramids. These gods being giants. Okay, you're referring to this last one I had up there. Looking fake with the big skull. I'm not saying they're not fake. Some of them, without a doubt, are probably photoshopped. But then again, maybe all these are photoshopped. But this is the History Channel. And these are skulls of giants with double rows of teeth. And supposedly, they did have double rows of teeth. Some of them, they had more than five fingers. And of course, we all know that the Nephilim was supposed to be a result of fallen angels mating with normal-sized women here on Earth. And their children they bore were Nephilim, were giants. And I've read where these giants were supposed to be carnivorous. They liked the flesh of man. I also read where some of them were cyclops, had one eye. And I heard eventually they all got wiped out by armies attacking them because they were, you know, feeding on the people. And also I heard that the last of them were removed from Earth by the Great Flood. So, I don't know, you know, it's all a matter of whether you believe it or you don't believe it. I got a lot of different pictures here, but the thing that bothers me is, you know, all these bones they found, legitimately found, archaeologists found this stuff, all disappeared. It's like the Men in Black went in these museums and they confiscated the bones. Like they don't want us to know about giants, same as they don't want us to know about UFOs. It's like a cover-up. It's like, that's what I've read anyway, and I believe that's probably true. Hi, Ghost Queen. Hi, Anna. Anne. Lori. Time Lord. So I just thought I'd start with today, talk to you about these things and see what you people thought. I've got a lot of pictures here that are pretty damn convincing. To me anyway. Now, is that photoshopped? It looks to me like maybe this guy was photoed over on top of all this. This looks like a photoshop to me. But there's some pictures you just can't refute. Like this one. This is in stone, people. Now, somebody didn't sit there and carve that out. And you can see the size of it compared to the human foot sitting on top of it. And I've got more like that. Oh, shoot. Really, that one. That could be photoshopped. Except for this guy's got a shadow. See that shadow there? And it's all staked out, like where they're doing the archaeological dig. And to me, that one looks like it's probably real, not photoshopped. But of course, you know, it's something we all have to accept or not accept. This one here, too, looks real. Don't know whether it is or not. This one here is, I don't know, could they have photoshopped all the people in there? Suppose they could have. Double rows of teeth. There's proof that there were double rows of teeth. The skull right there has got double rows of teeth. And they say that all of them, the Nephilim had double rows of teeth. Well, there you go, and that's the History Channel. And I've watched some shows about these. There you go, there's that same foot, look at that footprint. Now, how can you deny that? I mean, this is stone, and I don't think somebody come in there and cut a footprint out of stone. But the best one's even coming, let me get rid of that one, is this one here. The guy is standing next to this footprint. It's in Africa. And this footprint is. And people come up, and it's in a remote place. People trek and travel just to see it. And down below here, down by where his bottom of his very bottom of his legs are, there's like a ledge down there at the bottom of that foot, and people bring offerings. Do I have a close-up of that? No. Okay, it's South Africa. Said to be 3.1 billion years old. But anyway, had a close-up of this somewhere. But this is granite. It's granite. It's not sandstone. It's granite. Granite's a hard-ass rock. Now, this thing's standing straight up and down because I read about this story about this. Supposedly, it's located where there's tectonic plates, you know, on the earth that move. I mean, it gives us earthquakes. And at one time or another, there was an upheaval of them plates and made the plates stand up like that. That's why it's standing straight up and down. But this is granite. And I don't have a close above it, but you can actually see up there by the toes. Like when you walk in mud, you can actually see this on the close up I don't have. But it's on the internet if you search for this. You can see where the mud's squished up between the toes of this giant. You know, when you step down and the mud has to go somewhere, you can see between the toes where the mud actually squished up. Now, this looks like real to me. Of course, you know, they got pictures of Yeti footprints and Bigfoot footprints. They take them in the snow and they're huge. But they say that's due to, you know, if you take a regular footprint and then it starts melting, it'll enlarge. But this is granite, people. This this is granite. And I had another footprint somewhere that showed a human footprint like that with a dinosaur footprint over the top of it. Where the dinosaur had stepped onto the footprint of the human. So it's a subject that I like. And so I thought I'd see what you guys thought. And this one here probably is fake. If it's not, I mean, supposedly I've read where all these giants all came in different sizes. But one that big, he'd have to be at least 20 or 30 foot tall. And if there was such a thing, it sure would be easy for him to stack them blocks over there in the pyramids, wouldn't it? It's just a thought. And also raise them, what do you call them? Them big pillars that stand alone with the points on the top. Because some of them weigh like 200, 400 tons. And they say they laid them down, dug a hole, and then they would slide down and they'd keep digging them out until it was standing up. Well, what if they had one of these things running around, just stood it up for them? It's interesting. And it's too bad that people try to cover things up from us. That last picture of that footprint in granite, to me, that's telling. And I ran across lots of newspaper articles all over the United States, all over the world, where they find giants and archaeological digs, and they find them. They put the bones in a museum, and then they disappear. The bones disappear. Hi, Shadow Demon. So this is one thing paranormal that I think I gotta believe in. I believe. I mean, we've all heard the story of Goliath. We've all heard of Goliath. Was a giant. It's in the Bible. Giants are mentioned in the Bible. Of course, the Nephilim. Fallen angels mating with women on earth and result being giants. Because they weren't supposed to mate with them, and maybe guess that was the result. But if these giants love to eat humans, I can see why they're not around no longer. Yeah, I went through that earlier, Ann. Yeah. All the gods that they worshipped were all depicted as giant. What did I do with the picture of them? Naturally, I can't find it now. Actually, I can't find it. There we go. And here's a rugger-sized human. A pointer probably isn't working. But handing something up to the giant sitting on the chair there. And these were like the gods. And they see the sun up there. So that makes me think was it Osiris? The sun god? Was he the sun god? But they got the long, pointy heads. Maybe they're aliens. I don't know. Maybe they're giants. Who knows? But I noticed this over there in Egypt. There's lots of these things like this that depict them as being giant. Yep, six fingers, six toes. We have people here on Earth with six fingers and six toes, and double rows of teeth. It's a birth defect. But it does happen still. Still happens. People are still born with tails sometimes, little tail. So stuff like that still happens, but it's completely out of the ordinary. Yeah, 20 to 30 feet. Now, I said that and somebody said, oh, no, can't happen. I mean, you know, that's that first picture I showed right there. Somebody else said that one would have to be 100 feet. I don't know. Could be photoshopped. But like I was saying, if there ever was one that is that big, he could stack that them 2-ton blocks on the pyramids like they were marbles, like they were nothing. I would believe that first before I'd believe the aliens came down and cut them blocks for them and helped them with the pyramids, because I don't know. I don't believe nothing I hear about them pyramids. I can't believe that people would build ramps and drag them, all them blocks on logs and pull them with ropes with chain, tons of people pulling them blocks up that high, 400 feet high, and then having to get rid of all the ramps on it after they got done. I don't know, man. It just sounds too far-fetched to me, as far-fetched as this does. Yeah. Well, not really. If they're physically the same as a human, being taller ain't going to affect your balance any, because you're going to be, you know, heavier too than... humans. And they liked humans. They were... what do you call them? Cannibals. I read where a lot of the armies took up and went hunting them and stuff. They wanted to eliminate them because they were eating all the people. And I heard the last of them was swept away and swept off the earth by the flood. How the smaller humans survive? Run like hell. I don't think the earth was overrun by these things. There are probably just a few of them, you know. maybe 100 or so, or so. I don't think there was that many that people couldn't get away from or stay away from if they wanted to. The ones like that one though, they freaked me out right there. Hi, Leslie. Oh, are you okay there, Mike? Oh. Made that video this morning that I went over and watched TV for a while and dozed off and woke up, ate, and just got back in here in time to start this thing. Wife made some chili today, got me a bowl of that. Dang, 17 people today. I guess it does pay to advertise. So if anybody's watching, not talking, join in. Let's hear your views on giants. There's just too much stuff on the and around on the net and places that you it makes it undeniable as far as I'm concerned, especially pictures like this of a footprint in pure granite. Now that footprint's as big as that guy is, and that's from his knees to his head. Let's say I think a couple feet off. That footprint's got to be what, 4, 4.5, 5 foot big, the foot. So that might make that person awfully tall. Uh-oh. Ghost Queen must have snow. We don't got no snow here. No, I said 1 p.m. Kevin, I said 1 p.m. Yep, the Nephilim. Yep, that's right, Leslie. Oh, yeah, Ghost Queen. You're really going to want to shovel after you down some of that. No, Kevin, they said it was from tectonic plates and the earth coming together and they forced the stone up. And that's granite. That's not sandstone, that's granite. I didn't put out any notifications, Kevin. I didn't schedule it on YouTube. I made a video, and I posted the video as a notification, a short 4-minute video. And I did it that way because when you make a post a schedule on YouTube, it only goes to your subscribers. That's the only people go to, unless somebody wanders across your page. So I made an actual video and uploaded the video. By doing that, people on YouTube see it, people on Google Plus see it, and the people on Twitter see it, because my video goes out all three places. And I got 20 people in here already. Yeah, I'm on Eastern Time. They find them, Mike Lincoln, and then the government takes them. They disappear. There's all kinds of articles, newspaper articles, old articles, way back in the 1800s, where they found the bones. They ended up in museums or private collections or wherever the hell they end up, but the ones that end up in museums, they disappear. They disappear. The government don't want you knowing about them. They don't want you believing or knowing about the giants for some reason. It's like it's a big cover-up, like UFOs. They don't want you to know about them either. All the bones that have been dug up and stuff, they've disappeared. That's why it's so interesting. What the hell is so bad that they don't want you to know about them, you know? People panic over anything, so I guess if they thought there really was giants, I don't know why they panicked. That was thousands of years ago. I don't know, man. There's all kinds of bones in the mummies and stuff. They still got bones in them. Did you know why people get that idea about bones disintegrating? If you go out in the woods and look for deer antlers, you'll never find them because the mice eat them. When they fall on the ground, the mice eat them. The mice eat antlers. Of course, I don't know if they'd eat bones, but they eat antlers anyway. Goliath, of course, is mentioned in the Bible, and other giants too, you know. The Nephilim are mentioned. The government thinks it knows best. It knows better than you do. That's why they suppress stuff and don't want you to know about it. Some people just can't take any news of anything like that. I mean, people go nuts over nothing. I mean, look at this, look at this damn political shit since Trump got the goddamn world, the country and the world has gone topsy-turvy over one man. You know, they're all afraid he's going to blow us all up, and they're all afraid of this, and they don't like him, and they don't like his people he chose, and they I wouldn't be surprised if we had another civil war because of these goddamn leftist people that just can't stand it because they lost. Oh, Hillary lost, and they just can't believe it. Oh my God, I can't believe that. Well, let me cause hell. Let me raise hell and let me riot and let me do all this shit. And I tell you what, people are unbelievable. I've also heard there's supposed to be tunnels lacing the United States connected to underground bases, underground military bases across the United States, and they're connected by tunnels. You've all heard of supposedly the military installation under Deluce, Arizona there, I think it is. Is it Deluce? And they're supposed to be like 5 or 6 levels, and aliens are there, and we're in cahoots with aliens, and they give us technology, and we give them people to experiment on, and it just goes on and on and on. I go along with you, Mike. I kind of think that's true, too, that maybe not all, but I kind of feel that could be true, too. UFOs coming back in time, and it's actually us. Or maybe it's us, but there's nobody in them. I mean, what I'm saying is, you know how we have drones now, you know, unmanned drones. Maybe they got unmanned flying saucers from the future coming back and checking shit out. And, you know, who knows? You know, I also wonder about, what do they call it? You've heard of Middle Earth, that supposedly there's an Earth within the Earth. Now, that's kind of far-fetched to me, because I still think it's molten lava in the middle of the Earth. If you go down there, you're going to be sorry. Who, me? Oh, yeah. Did you hear my video, Ghost Queen? I made about this? Hi, Julie. Welcome. Got 22 people watching. Oh, 1-2, 1-2. Oh, 1-2, 1-2. No, it's not gonna work. Why isn't it gonna work? Waiting for an application to use the microphone. Okay, hang on. Okay, I tried something, it didn't work. Yeah. I think sooner or later we're gonna know all about it. I'm gonna know all about everything. When that day comes, that fateful day that everybody faces, we're gonna know about it. It makes you mad. How many toes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 toes. Big toe. And there's another set of prints in a rock. Makes it kind of hard to dispute, doesn't it? The only reason they haven't got rid of, I'm surprised they haven't went in there with a jackhammer and jackhammered all the rocks out so nobody could see them. I don't want to brag, but you ought to see the size of my foot and leg. Alright, you can safely call me Bigfoot, Big Leg. I've been eating too much salt lately, man. My leg is so big, it's the biggest I've ever seen it. I'm a dumbass. I don't know why I keep doing what I do. Maybe I got a death wish. I'm not supposed to eat salt. I bought me some radishes the other day. You can't eat a radish without salt. So I've been putting sea salt on them. Luckily, they're just about gone. Just got to quit this shit. Paraghoster, Amazon, and Google are going to take over the world with their clone, little clone things flying around. Well, thanks for stopping, Angela. I don't know if you're in the wrong room or not. Greek American guy. I watched one on History Channel. I think they had a documentary on it. Uh-oh. I hear my granddaughter. I can hear her squeaky shoes. Hey, Squeaky. Come here, Squeaky. Squeaky girl. You gonna come see Grandpa? Lucy. Come see Grandpa. Well, thank you, Jessica. I don't do anything. Not on purpose. I never do anything on purpose. Because I get blamed for it. Well, I learned my lesson the other day. No more talking about anybody in any way, shape, or form. None of my favorites. None of the other paranormal people say anything, and then you get your head taken off. You get jumped on for no reason. Well, maybe I give him a reason. I don't know, but after the other day, I'm done talking about anybody whatsoever. Hello, Portsmouth. Oh, Jessica. You knew people were just discussing ancient giants, how they fit into the paranormal, and how they have the truth about them has been suppressed by the man that don't want us to know about them. Their bones have disappeared from museums and so forth. But discussion is open to anything. Doesn't even have to be paranormal. This can just be how awesome I look. I didn't think I did. I was going to go back and try and listen about that, but I don't know. I did say later on after that I didn't like people on here that hid behind a mask. And I don't. I mean, what's the reason for hiding behind a mask? What are you afraid of, you know? But that's my opinion. Then as much as I hate haters, I was just being one the other day, and I gotta quit that crap. Kumbaya, kumbaya. No, I don't have parakeets. I gave them away. When I had them before, I was a younger man, and I could get around, and I could do things, and I wanted some because I missed having them around, and I got them, and too much work for the old man. Throw that damn seed just everywhere. And won't shut up. Cover them up. I had them covered up more than they was uncovered, and you're not supposed to do that. I mean, you know, they're too close in the proximity of my TV. They'd start making so much noise, I couldn't hear the TV sitting in front of it. So I give them to my son. He's got three of them now. The two I originally bought and the one I bought him, now he's got three. Hey, Squeaky. You gonna come see Grandpa? Hey there, young lady. What you doing? What you got? I got a ball. Come here, see me. Oh, you're heavy. You're a heavy girl, aren't you? Huh? Can you say hi? Say hi. Can you say hi? Huh? Look right in there. See in there? Say hi. My name's Lucy. That's a girl. Wave. 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 Do it. You can do it. Wave. Like this. Say, my name's Lucy. My name's Lucy. You wanna play with the mouse? She likes my mouse because it's got lights on it. No, don't push buttons. She likes my keyboard because it lights up, my mouse because it lights up. Don't you, girl? Huh? Don't you? Huh? What are you doing? Oh, you got a little ponytail today. You got rid of your pigtails? You got a little ponytail. Huh? Mm. Yeah. Oh, you got painted fingernails. Pretty. Look at that. See that? Yeah. You got dirt under your nails, too. Oh, no, no, no. You don't want to push buttons. No, no. You didn't want to push buttons. Want to get down? No? Won't get down? No, you don't need nothing down there. No, you don't need my keyboard. Grandma's gonna let you back down. Say bye. Oh, say bye. Say bye-bye. Bye-bye. Did you hear her squeaker? Her shoes? Yeah, she gets into everything, boy. You gotta... That's why we keep them squeaker shoes on her so you can keep track of her. Her mom says once she's silent for too long, she's gotta go check on her. She don't hear that squeaker, she's into something. Yeah, pushing buttons is fun. She likes my keyboard because it lights up, see? Red or blue or purple. Well, she likes that, boy. She's drawn that like a fly to a light. When I don't have the computer on, I let her bang on all she wants to. All this computer stuff nowadays has lights on it. It's not going to show. There, Atlas. Look right underneath the mic. It's my mouse. It changes colors automatically. It changes... cycles through a whole bunch of colors. She likes anything like that. All kids like that. That's what I was telling you the other day about. You want to sell something? You want to sell a ghost box? Put some lights on it. People love lights. And I got her two pairs of those squeaker shoes. That's the second pair. The first pair, I don't know if she wore them out. One of the squeakers quit working. So then I bought a pair of red ones for Christmas, go with a Christmas outfit fit, and one of the squeakers quit in that one. They sell the squeakers separately. They just pull out and they push into the sole. They're real. Oh, they got all kinds of keyboards that light up. I got a new one I'm looking at. This has mechanical switches in it. Hey, 20 people watching. Where am I now with this? Oh, there we go. Nothing now. Yeah, I think a lot of these pictures are probably photoshopped. That one I got is kind of iffy whether it is or not because you can see the guy's shadow. Of course, I guess they could photoshop the shadow and all, but you got all these like pins, stakes he's got. He's got the area staked out like an a guy that digs the dirt would do. Well, I don't know about that one. That one might be real, maybe not. That one there could be photoshopped. To me, it doesn't look like it. Because he's got his brush right here brushing that thing. And you can see the size of him compared to the skeleton. This one over here is laying right on top of a little skeleton. That one there, I'm not so sure might be real, too. Oh, I hear a squeakers. Yeah, I knew the name, just couldn't get it out. What's up, girl? What you got now? What you drinking? Huh? Fruit? Barrel? You drinking fruit juice, girl? Who put a damn nipple on it? You can't burn that have a nipple on there. Oh, it's not a nipple. Okay. You better not have a nipple on there. Well, that picture there looks real to me. And they say that all of them had double rows of teeth. All the better to chew the humans with, I guess. Double rows of teeth and six toes and fingers. What up? You want to come back again? Oh, okay. Oh, boy. Say, I'm back. You still want them lights, don't you? You can't have them. No? Tell them that's not a teat. That's one of them fold down like a water bottle. What do you see up there? Huh? What's that up there? Huh? Good? Is that good? You out there bugging your grandma? Huh? You decided to come in here and bug your grandpa? Huh? Yeah? Oh. Because it's a... I've read about it. They said they did. They were cannibalistic. You done? Still got a little bit left in there. You gonna get down? You gonna go back for grandma again? Huh? You gonna get going back for grandma again? Huh? Grandpa get you? Huh? Okay. Go back with grandma. She's gonna be worried if she can't hear your squeakers. Go see grandma. Bye. Oh boy. More bacon. Maybe we tasted like bacon. Yeah, but that's most of your giants nowadays have that hormone pituitary gland defect, and that's why they grow so tall. And ends up killing him in the long run. You know, the whole bunch of tallest people in the world have died from that because your bones get thin and you can't support your weight. And people that have that that gland problem. Hello, everyone. You're welcome. Yeah, I've heard that too. That's why when somebody said bacon. Let's just face it, people. We're the other white meat, and it ain't chicken. Yeah, I'm feeling better, Lori. Various day to day. There's been a lot of cannibalistic people, April. I'm sure the ones that did it know. Not bad people either. I mean, there's been serial killers, you know, Jeffrey Dahmer, was a crazy farmer that skinned them and made lamps, and I can't think of his name right offhand. But then there's been Jeffrey Dahmer he's a killer and a cannibal, but he also was a damn doctor. Or lawyer or something, and he wasn't dumb. I suppose if somebody asked him what people taste like, he'd tell them, you know. But pork's the ongoing. Cut your butt and your thigh off and have bacon for weeks. They just call me Big Pig. Yeah, Ed Gein. He was a winner. There was a real famous one over in the UK, too. Hey, Ghost Queen, don't knock it till you try it. Well, I've heard of the one-eyed, one-eared, flying purple people eater. I've heard of him. Well, make sure it's well done, Ghost Queen. You wouldn't want no raw people. Oh yeah, they crashed up in the Rocky Mountains, or up in the mountains where snow and stuff was. I remember that. I think I seen the movie. Haven't heard from Kevin in a while. You still there, Kevin? I don't mean to ignore anybody. I don't watch the chat like I should. I get distracted easily. We do a lot of things that we don't think we do. I'm pretty sure of that. No, I didn't see that, Lori. I quit listening to that Eric when they started doing interviews with Hitler and Jesus and President Lincoln and stuff like that. And I said, that's enough for me. My respect went right down the drain. Ghost Queen, I'm not going to touch that. A 10-foot pole or any pole. That's big enough. 9 or 10 feet tall, that's big enough. Well, I was really interested in that channeling Eric when he first made videos on about spirits and about ghosts and all that stuff. And some of the very first ones he made, it sounded reasonable and sounded true. And I liked him. I think I even got him on my webpage or links to him. But after that, they just kept getting crazier and crazier. And now that I see that one woman she used to have channel for all the time is not channeling for her anymore. And she's gone through about 2 or 3 others since then. So I don't know what the deal is with that doctor. Too enthusiastic, I think. But what one person's cup of tea is, isn't for somebody else, so. I'm sorry, Ghost Queen, I took that the wrong way. That was one of them statements where you leave yourself open, you know? I think any of that psychic shit I don't 100% believe in. I like that Amy Allen, but she, if she supposedly can talk to all these dead spirits, and she says she can see them, and she can talk to them, but yet she doesn't channel them. Why don't she channel them? She can't channel them, but yet she can talk to them and see them. Why does she have to go around walking through this house and gather all this information? You know? I don't know. I just... That Caputo, she's a complete Sylvia Brown as far as I'm concerned. She just lives off of poor people's feelings. Well, they're poor after she gets done with them. But she lives off their feelings, and a lot of them psychics I have no goddamn use for. None whatsoever. Calm down, Ghost Queen. It'll be okay. Calm down. Calm down now. Yep. She's probably down in the damn pit paying for it, too, I hope. What's that special whip with the tails on it? What the hell is it called? It cuts you open every time it hits you? She's down there in the pit, and the old demons are flailing on her. I would say they'd hang her by her you-know-whats, but she don't have any, so the whip would do. That puts her in a class with other people we know that's in the paranormal field. I hope they end up same goddamn place. It's starting to come here. It's 39 degrees right now. What would that be in centigrade? I have no idea. But it's warming up gradually. Don't make any difference to me. This means I'm going to have to get an air conditioner sooner than I was going to. Then I'll go out of the damn house, so really don't make much difference to me. That's warm there, April. supposed to take advantage of that ghost queen. When they're home, you're supposed to make them wait on you. Kitchen video? I don't know what you're referring to. You talking about EVPs? I get them 24 hours a day. But I don't talk to them ones down there. I think they're evil as hell. Oh, things making noises? Yeah. They can use anything to make noise or make EVPs. Basically, they don't need anything at all. I don't believe they thinking. I don't believe they need any type of noise to come through. I put a video up here the other day. I can't remember which one it was now. Oh, the one where we heard the out-of-body voice that says hello, and you guys heard it too. I went back through that video, and I put it in my audio editor, put my headphones on, started listening, and them damn evil bastards that talk to me all the time, they were in here talking the whole video, making comments on what you people were saying, and what I was saying, and they were there the whole damn time. Full sentences. You don't want to talk to us, Larry. We know that. Something about you being as sick as you are, you should worry about talking with God, not talking with us. I mean, just all kinds of nasty shit, and they were in there the whole thing. I can't get away from them. Oh, when I was cooking, yeah. Yeah, I heard it, yeah. Plain as day. Those things that talk to me, they act like there's two of them. There's always two of them. And they've tried to deceive me and pretend they were my mother, tried to deceive me, pretend they were my grandfather. But whenever I talk to them, it's like one is a good guy and one's a bad guy. Good cop, bad cop. The good ones tell me I should read the Bible and I'll do this and all that. The other ones, just downright evil. So I don't know what to think of it. To me, it seems like they're my conscience, you know? You got the devil on one shoulder and then an angel on the other. It's like, that's what this prayer is. Don't know where the hell they come from, but they will not go away. They're always there. No matter how long you forget about them, you go back and they're there. And I had somebody else, one of my subs, tell me that they tried it and they were there for him too. Of course, they weren't my guys, they were his guys. And they're always there. Okay, let me see if I can bring that hello in here. Hope I don't screw this whole thing up here. Because I am recording everything here. Let me see. February videos. Okay. Okay. Hello? Hello? I heard somebody say hello. Out of body voice? I heard somebody say hello. Okay, now pay attention. When I first click on this, it's there. You gotta turn up your volume and really listen. I should have given it some space before it started, but it starts as soon as I hit this button. And I'm gonna start it now. Listen carefully. There it went. Did you hear it? Hello. Hello? Hello? I heard somebody say hello. Out of body voice? Thought I heard somebody say hello. Nope, Mark. Well, that was it. Here comes Squeaky.
Hi, Squeaky. What are you doing, girl? Huh? What you doing? You want to come up again? Huh? You do? You're getting on your tippy toes. Okay, okay. Oh, man. I don't know how much longer I'm going to be able to lift you up here, girl. You're getting to be a package. You know that? You're getting to be a package like Grandpa.
Oh, you heavy, girl. Oh, you want a drink? Okay, let me get you over here.
Let me sit right there.
Okay, you sit right there. I'll get you a drink. Hang on. Cold water. You going to drink it all? Good? Huh? That good? Oh, you're pushing on the keyboard. Don't do that. We don't know what's going to happen. You'll have to turn something off or on. What? Red. It's a mouse pad. Mouse pad. You want to know what everything is? Everything, don't you? What's that? Junk. That's junk up there. I'm going to let you down again, girl. Don't fall. You going to go with Grandma? Bye-bye. Bye-bye.
I live for them grandkids. I live for her.
Oh, speaking of psychic, I wanted to ask you guys about something. Because I know absolutely nothing on the subject. Astral projection. Or out-of-body dreams. So I've been having some weird shit happen to me for months now. You know how you try and go to sleep and you're right on the edge of falling asleep? Well, at that time, maybe, you know, my mind wanders off and I start thinking about something. Like about some friend of mine or some place I've been or
some damn thing about that. And then that ends up being my dream. I was thinking about a friend of mine that has already passed on, and I fell asleep, and I'll be damned, the dream was about him. You know, nothing made a hell of a lot of sense, still crazy dream stuff, but that's like been happening to me, you know. I'll think of something before I fall off, and then I'll have the dream about it. Hello, Muse of Purgatory. You're new around here. Welcome. We all were too. I'll have to start somewhere. About a half hour more, people, and I'm going to pack it in. My leg won't take any more than that. I got a big heavy-duty desk chair I set in here, but my leg is so bad, and it cuts right across your thigh behind your knee, and it just cuts the circulation off of my leg, and I ain't got any to start with, so it ends up killing me. So I can't take it but about another half hour, and then I'm going to get out of here. But I'm surprised, 24 people in there right now.
Normally I have 5, 6, 7, 8. Of course, not many people are up at 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning. Kevin was here. I didn't say much to him, I guess, and maybe he took off. Like I was ignoring him, but I wasn't. I don't pay enough attention to the chat, and sometimes I ignore people and don't mean to. If you haven't did this, try it sometime. It's hard to keep up with the chat window. You got to keep up with it. If you don't, it moves off screen, and then you can't see what they ask you in the first place. Hello, Angela. Welcome. Make them kids go out there and shovel. When I was a kid, I used to have to shovel the damn sidewalk and the driveway. All you need to do is bring the hammer down, get you another Red Bull, and sit there in the window and watch them shovel. Tell them they can come back in. You'll make them something warm to eat after they're done. No, I don't plan on ranting. Trying to get away from that stuff. Doesn't do any good to rant. Doesn't do any good to hate on people. I hated on some the other day. I shouldn't have. It's 2:26 p.m. here too. I'm in the lower part of Michigan, 80 miles west of Detroit, 30 miles south of the capital. Well, I had them, two people and, well, maybe a couple others that just stick in my craw, and I try and forget them, but sometimes I lose my cool. I go to their YouTube page and I see their latest, and it just POs me so bad, and I should know better. It's like I said, it's like driving by an accident. You don't want to look, but you just can't help yourself. Yeah, when I was a kid, me and my friend used to go shoveling sidewalks on purpose. We put the old shovels over our shoulder like a troll or whatever. And we go from door to door asking to shovel sidewalks. You know, we'd take our money, we'd get 50 cents or $1 or $2 to shovel a walk. With two of us, it didn't take long. And then we got all done, we'd go down to Kmart. Was it Kmart? No. Shit, what's the name of that store? I don't even think there's any around anymore. Shopper's Fair. Now, that'll show your age if you've ever heard of a Shopper's Fair. It's sort of like a Kmart, but it's a Shopper's Fair. We just go to Shopper's Fair and go down there and buy model car kits. Then we spend the rest of the day putting the model car kits together and painting them and making them as nice as we could. And then we take them down to the basement and we set them up on cardboard boxes. And we destroy them and shoot them with our BB guns. I'm not mentioning that guy's name. I said something the other day, and he come in here and made a comment. Come unglued. I don't know if it's towards me or what somebody said about him. I don't know. Don't need that shit. It's drama. Try to stay away from the drama. Here I was making it. shame on me. Yurik, I don't know if I pronounced your name right. You need an intervention, buddy. You need a priest. You need a big bottle of holy water. You need some white sage. Well, you know, some people, you don't need to do anything wrong. All you need to do is mention a name, or I said this a million times before. When you're on the internet, you have to walk on glass, because you never know when somebody's going to take offense at something you say. If there's no ill intent behind it or anything, it doesn't matter. Some people just are off the wall, you know. You just, people are people, and I'm no psychiatrist. I don't know nothing about them. They're all strangers to me, but man, you know, sometimes you say something and somebody will take it the wrong way, and then you have hell to pay, and it's not worth it. I don't want to say anything about, I'm no longer going to say anything about anybody whatsoever if I can help it. And if I do, remind me. Because sometimes I say shit jokingly and don't mean it, but people take it the wrong way. Everybody does that, I guess. You know, the bad thing with them personal experiences is that that's all they are, personal experience. I mean, you can tell somebody about it, and you can tell that they're sincere about it happening, but there's nothing like proof in the pudding, you know? It's like my door closed there 2 or 3 days in a row. Remember hearing me? Remember me telling about my door closing? It's never done it since. Did it 3 days in a row. Never done it since. Used to see shadows go down my hallway there 2 or 3 times. Haven't seen nothing lately. Last night I was sleeping, went to bed, and my closet doors were closed, and I woke up, I don't know, about 1 o'clock in the morning, and I thought about taking another orb video, just whipping my camera out there and see if I could catch any orbs, and I looked and my damn closet door was open, and I didn't open it. It's just, you know, but it's one of them accordion doors, you know, where the two doors fold in against each other and that holds them closed. It may have just popped open during the night. I don't know. You can call lots of shit paranormal. It's not paranormal. It may seem strange to you. It may sound paranormal to somebody else, but I don't mean it is. You know? Now, if I'd have stood here and had that on camera and watched it pop open, it still might not have been paranormal because of the way them doors close. They're accordion, and when you close them in against one another, the pressure of them coming against one another is what holds them closed. You know, lots of things you can debunk and lots of things you can't. No, tell me to shut my trap. Well, Portsmouth possessed. I didn't get possessed, but I got oppressed. I think I had two attachments to them, and the ones that I talk to all the time, down deep in the noise, and they're, I think one's good, one's evil, and I still don't know what the hell they are, but I think they attached themselves to me once. Because when you hear voices and you're not on the radio, you're not even around the radio, you're out in the kitchen getting something to eat and you hear voices, you don't need that, you fat son of a bitch. You know you don't want that. You're already fat, and that's coming in your out of your head, from inside your head, then you know something's friggin' wrong. Yeah, gets me in trouble sometimes. Lady Jenny, hey, welcome. If we've ever talked before either. Welcome to the fray. Well, you know, those of us that talk on ghost boxes and get EVPs and all this stuff and have did it for a long time, I think we're more privy to this stuff happening because of our experience with it and doing it for such a long time. But not only that, we're more aware, you know? You take something that has absolutely nothing to do with paranormal, and you know, a ghost could come up next to them and fart in their face and they wouldn't smell it. You or me, it might knock us over, you know? I mean, because we're aware, and most people aren't aware of paranormal things going on around them. Couldn't get any more personal, Leslie. They told me we were kindred spirits, and more or less they told me they were me. They told me things about my mother and my grandfather that absolutely nobody would know but me. But that's how I caught them in their lies. They said something about me, about my mother, and it was a flat-out lie, and I knew it, and I caught them in it. Then another time, they tried deceiving me that he was my grandfather. And my grandfather hung himself in the basement of my mother's house. And the reason he did that is because he was depressed and sad because my father had died a few weeks before that. And my grandfather was 86 years old, and my father was, I think, 49 years old. And he was depressed and sad because his son died before him. So he took his life. He jumped out, laid out all his items, his watch, his wallet, everything, laid him out nicely in a row. And I don't think he left a suicide note. But he put a noose around one of the beams of the house and stepped up on a chair and put it around his neck and stepped off. My mother found him in the basement. Well, these damn things were trying to deceive me about being my grandfather. And I says, yeah, my grandfather was sad. And they said something about something. And I says, no, that's a damn lie. I said, I caught you. You're that's a damn lie. My grandfather killed himself because he was depressed about my dad passing away. And I caught him in a damn bold-faced lie. So then they come out and they says, okay, you got us. You're smarter than we are. You're right, blah, blah, blah. They told me they were in hell and wanted to know if I'd like to join them. And I said, hell no, I don't want to join you. So yeah, they were real personal with me, Leslie. I think it was Leslie. And they got in my head, Leslie, and I couldn't do nothing, man. I mean, everywhere I went to do something, you know, it's like you had the devil on one shoulder and the angel on the other. And they were in my head. I thought I was actually going friggin' mad. You know? Just everything I did, they'd make a comment about it. They'd comment about it. I'd get out and try and do a ghost session. They said, oh, that's a lie. That guy ain't telling you the truth. I mean, you know, they had something to say about everybody, anything, and everything. But I was oppressed, not possessed. I wasn't barfing pea soup or my head spinning around 360 degrees. So. How I got rid of them is I quit messing with the paranormal, period, for about 3 or 4 weeks. And during that time, I prayed to God to help me and to get rid of them. And I finally did. How you get rid of them is up to you. I sage myself and anything you can think of, you know. But I finally got rid of them. And that's why now I don't, they'll still talk to me anytime, but I don't talk to them. I avoid them with a, no, I have nothing to do with them. Sometimes I'll go there by mistake, you know, and I hear them, but I know they're still there and that's the end of it. I ain't talking to them. Yeah, it's a voice changer. You didn't like my demon impression? Well, I wasn't in my house here. But my grandfather was not a bad man. He was a good man. I remember him rocking me on in his rocking chair when I was a little kid and I wore jammies with feet in them. I can remember that like it was yesterday. He was a thin, frail old man, smoked a big stinky pipe with, what the hell is that tobacco? Can't even think of it now. It came in a red can. But I can remember that stuff like it was yesterday. He wouldn't do anything to ever hurt me. Ignoring them goes a long ways there, Leslie. Don't think about them. Don't give them the time of day. Don't answer them. Don't say anything to them. Just completely ignore them. If you don't talk to them, they can't talk back, right? They'll get sick of talking to themselves after a while when they know you're not going to talk to them. I'm fine as long as I don't try and get EVPs. As soon as I get an EVP, it's them. I don't care what kind of EVP, it's them. So I don't do EVPs no more. The only thing I get is off the radios if I get anything. If I don't go around with a recorder. If I do, it's them. Bye, Julie. Thanks for stopping by. About 12 more minutes, guys, and I'm going to get out of here. My leg will be ready to fall off about that time. I'm going to go watch some TV, I guess. Probably fall asleep again. Sleep all afternoon, and then when tonight comes, I won't be able to sleep. That's normally what I do. That's why I end up getting up at 3, 4 o'clock in the morning, because I slept all day. Bad habits. When you retire, you get bad habits. Bad habits. I've just wondered, it seems everybody has these spirits attached to them. Whether they're oppressing you or not, but they are with everybody, it seems to be. Because I had another person tell me that they tried it and they were there for them. But it wasn't my, you know, it was their personal demons or whatever the hell they are. But I think they're there for everybody, and I don't know what the purpose of them is. I don't know if it's good or bad. I mean, I don't know if that one is good and the other is bad. Sometimes, you know, that evil one is evil as hell. It tells me dirty, rotten things. And the other one tells me, oh, you ought to read the Bible. You ought to, in your health condition, you ought to be trying to make peace with God and all this and all that. And I'm thinking to myself, well, if both of these things are evil, why the hell would that one be telling me that? I mean, I don't think that would come out of a demon's mouth. You know? So, I don't know. Don't know what they are. Sometimes I think that maybe they're our conscience. And we all got good and evil in us. Maybe that's our good and evil conscience or something. I don't know. I have no idea what the hell they are. But I wish to tell you, I'd have never found them. I ran across them by mistake. I exploited them because I thought I found something in the paranormal that nobody else had ever found. And I wish I'd never found them. Okay, guys, I'm going to get out of here, man. My leg's killing me. I can hear all squeaky shoes out there in the kitchen. I'm going to fill up my ice jug. Go get my chair. But this was fun. I had fun. I don't know if I'll ever do another one like this again, but I guess we could. On another subject, maybe somebody will give me suggestions for next time. I don't know. Whatever you guys want to talk about. But we got everybody's opinion on the Giants. And next time, maybe we can hash over something different.
Thank you, Zara. Thanks, Tim C. Thanks for coming. Thank everybody for coming. You're welcome, Jessica. You use a purgatory. Thank you. Fort Smells Possessed. Anne. Ghost Queen. All of you, whoever's left. 23 people in there. Thank everybody for showing up. Thank everybody for taking part. And see you next time. I'm sure there'll be a next time. Toodaloo. Toodaloo.